us and as generous as ever for standing in front of you by the reason of saying no in this motion, which says developed nations are the source of problems in Africa. Of course, dear judge, I do oppose this motion through my own unquestionable point that I have in my piece of paper. Firstly, violation of democratic principle. Additionally, presence of tribalism. Conclusively, lack of free and fair election. So, Mr. Judge, before going further, let me explain to you concerning my first point, which says violation of democratic principle. Precisely, we've been evermore witnessing one among the principles of democracy is about constitution. Returning the definition of the of constitution, which says is a body of law and principle whereby a country is governed through it. So, Mr. Judge, we've been evermore witnessing Africans themselves are practicing their own constitution in a bad way. For example, we've been evermore witnessing in Zimbabwe, in Burundi, through their own president, Pierre Nkurunziza. He's the one who breaks down his own constitution. In lieu of staying 2 terms, he has increased it is already. This shows obviously that Africans themselves are the source of problem. If it is not enough, Mr. Judge, we've been evermore witnessing in Zimbabwe through their only president, Robert Mugabe. More constitutionally, he's supposed to stay 2 terms. Selfishly, he doesn't want to leave his power proudly. This shows obviously that Africans themselves are the source of problems. But having happened this kind of problems, the 5 vectors power step down and start discussing it. This shows obviously that Africans themselves are the source of problems, especially America, China, Russia, England, and Italy as well. This shows obviously that Africans themselves are the source of problem, but it's not about developing nations. Mr. Diaz, you may see it by your own eyes. And you, my opposing team, you have to understand that emancipate yourself from mental slavery. No one but ourselves will see our mind. Additionally, presence of tribalism. Physically, we've been evermore witnessing, obviously, Africans themselves are by far the most aggressive for what they are doing, because they themselves are discriminating each other, owing to having different regions, tribes, color, classes as well. For example, Mr. Judge, we've been evermore witnessing in Burundi, between Fulani and Igbo. Both of them are living in the same country. They were fighting against rights, though. So many conflicts happen just as they practice it. For example, people were killed innocently. This shows obviously that Africans themselves are the source of problem. If it is not enough, we've been evermore witnessing in Nigeria between Fulani and Igbo. Both of them had gone so far as for fighting each other. Not only fight each other, also kill each other. This shows obviously that Africans themselves are the source of problem. Relentlessly, the United Nations tries the slightest remedy to make sure that they can get the best prosperity on it. This shows obviously that developed nations are not the source of problems in Africa, but are the source of removing tribalism in Africa. Dear Judge, I've got this vivid.
Thank you. Clap him. Clap. Yes. I just want to say that he was the second speaker from opposing sides. Right now, I just want to welcome the
Allah just get my deepest acknowledgement to Almighty God. One, we now surround me to peace in this moment. Secondly, Allah thank High Table in general, yes, team, no team, with the getting over you, my fellow students, for your being in this moment. Everybody, good evening. I am very happy to be in front of your eyes for the convenience of supporting the motion which says developed nations are the source of problem in Africa. I do support this motion due to my unquestionable points that I have. My first point says democracy, my second point says disease, and my third point says hesitating to solve problem in Africa. starting with democracy. First and foremost, we all understand the meaning of the word democracy. Democracy is a system of government in which all people of country can vote to elect their representative. And also we ought to understand the basic principle of democratic government. First of all, voting election, civic meeting, as well as discussing public issues. We have to ask ourselves how and why Jack Nation, how and why developed nation are the source of problem in Africa through democracy. We get to know inside the first constitutional amendment of introducing multi-party system in Africa, 1971. The life and economic of Africa totally committed to become life expectancy by giant countries. And we couldn't be far too gentlemanly. This result, the violation of democracy principle. And it is same as to understand giant nation killed the ghost that laid the golden eggs in Africa through democracy. The viewed example is about the president of Burundi, who is so-called Pierre Nkurunziza. This man is so-called Pierre Nkurunziza. He was very curious to know about his end of his power. But after knowing his end of his power, he could increase the years. This shows that the violation of democracy principle is took place down there. Apart from that, is about Zanzibar election. As we understand that, four months ago, we had an election here in Zanzibar. And we could realize that after having that kind of thing, first of all, citizens were very gentlemanly of understanding the result of examination. But after knowing that, citizens could recognize that the violation of democracy principle took place. Mr. the Judge, you may see it by your own. Apart from that, it's about disease. As we understand that disease is a deviation from normal health, despite the fact that disease is one of a kind, has been disturbing people's lives as well as immunity. While we know that immunity is ability of body to resist infection disease, as we understand that our immune system has been dropping away since that disease. Scientifically, many horrific and chronic disease rise from different developed nations. The video example of this is about pandemic disease. While we know that this is a kind of disease which affects whole country, continent, or world. The video example is about HIV and AIDS as well as Ebola fever. Talking about HIV and AIDS is about human immunovirus, and talking about AIDS is about acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. As we understand that this kind of disease is transmitted by sexual intercourse as well as sharing razor blood. If there is no relief, it's about Ebola fever. Well, we know that this is a very serious disease which is caused by virus which causes internal part of the body to lose much blood and ends with death. So we have to ask ourselves, are we ready to see our brothers and our sisters who can beat the nation are decimated by the reason of this kind of disease? Absolutely not. So through this fact, I can say obviously that developed nations are the source of problem in Africa. And also in the part of disease, we ought to understand that right now, we just have two types of disease. The first one is so-called man-made disaster, and the second one is so-called natural disaster. Talking about man-made disaster, this is a kind of disease which is made by someone from developed nation. The video example of this is about HIV and AIDS, as well as Ebola fever. Mr. Jaja.
Thank you. Something like that. Right now, I just want to welcome the last speaker from opposing sides. Just clap Facebook, go for it. 4 minutes.
Okay, well, Father, for saying anything, I'd like to call in my glorious son to my God, going to high table in Europe, my dear opposing team, my fourth supporting team, ladies and gentlemen, good evening to everyone.
Evening.
Definitely, I am fresher, happier, cooler than ever. Being with your eyes, with a light to oppose the motion which says, the Lord's nation are the source of problems in Africa. I do say now this question due to my refutable points that I have in my piece of paper. Firstly, existence of border conflict among the Africans themselves, as the most so because Africans themselves practice impeachment. Lastly, national waste in African country. Dear Judge, I get the show on the road with the existence of border conflict in African continent. Really, dear Judge, this is palatable fact that border conflict has been coming off and coming out in African continent over and over again. And this irresistible fact is that this problem is very critical for the many. Many of the time, many a person has been getting the difficulties of controlling their life all the harder. However, whoever needs to manage their own life all the better, this seems surely that Africa themselves are all people in Africa. But more perilously, a considerable number of innocent people cut off innocently. And alternatively, an enormous amount of people are fighting against each other, owing to border conflict. This surely that Africa themselves the problem in Africa. Dear Judge, I'm an example of Polakoff in Africa, chosen in Malawi, in Lake Nyasa, chosen in Kenya, in Kilimanjaro Mountain. And the saying is that only to have this problem, only to have this problem can cause different effect. And a good many people become both as insufferable as insupportable as ever. But the reason of all this kind of thing, and this brings tears, only to see many people become in this situation. This surely that Africa themselves are the source of problems in Africa. And you men as a foreign team, you have to understand that those who make physical revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. Due to this, I oppose this motion to the rest of my life. Secondly, Africa themselves practice investment. Really, dear Judge, investment is a situation whereby the people steal money that they're responsible for or belong to their people. Understandably, this is an objectionable fact is that embargo has been practicing in Africa over and over again, with the result of having this creditable leader. I also believe that owing to having them, different problems have been coming out in African countries. Depending on transparent international report, Africans are front line in terms of having investment in their country. Among the countries that which has investment in Africa, Tanzania, South Africa, South Sudan, Libya, Kenya, and other. Have a look in Tanzania, under the office of TRA, Richard Bade. And if not enough, in South Africa, under President Jacob Zuma, he took much money from the public wealthy, knowing that 17.1% of people are not employed. It could be better by far if he would provide those money for the need in such a way that he can help those people. And it can help those people. This is automatic is that Africa themselves are sort of problem in Africa. And you, man, supporting team, you have to understand that peaceful is a journey of 1,000 miles. It can take a time on it. So, due to this, I can say, developed nations are the source of protecting peace and harmony in Africa. Dear Judge, you may see by your own eyes. Lastly, natural waste in Africa.
Thank you. Clap him. Into that's another phase. It's about contributors. Talking about the first contributor, should he spend 5 minutes, the same thing as speakers, and the rest one, 4 minutes. Without wasting our time, I just want to welcome the first speaker from supporting side. The first speaker.
Okay, well, I currently like to provide my sincere gratitude and appreciation to my God for enabling you and me being happy as the day is long today. And all, I'd like to thank High Table in general, yes team and no team, without forgetting you, my fellow student, ladies and gents, good evening to everyone.
Evening.
Precisely, I am terribly over the moon, being before your eyes, my fellow student. I'm standing here enthusiastically and deliberately in consequence of supporting this motion which says developed nations are the source of problem in Africa. So of course, Mr. Dear Judge, I do support this motion. Depending on my infallible points which I have. The first one is developed nations are the source of motivating homosexualities. Eventually, developed nations are the source of raising enmity and hostility among African countries. So, dear Judge, allow me to explain my point accurately. The first one is developed nations are the source of motivating homosexuality. Of course, Mr. Dear Judge, before going further, I'd like to provide the significance of homosexuality. Homosexuality means the romantic attraction, sexual attraction, or sexual behavior between members of the same sex or genders. Presumably, we got used to hearing again and again from developed nations that African countries won't get even a little bit of aid, without the question of homosexuality being bearable and viable and practicable in African continent, given the fact that these policies goes against the most of African cultures. So, dear Judge, proving this de facto fact, David Cameron could say publicly and deliberately that homosexuality should be practiced by African people. So, dear Judge, you may see it by your own eyes. So, through this fact, Mr. Dear Judge, you know, I can say that, you know, I can say that developed nations are the source of big problem in Africa, and not Africans themselves. Exceedingly, I like to criticize someone, you know, who has come here and said, Africans themselves got used to practicing nepotism. So of course, Mr. Dear Judge, you know, you don't understand the meaning of nepotism. Nepotism is the giving unfair advantages to our own families. If you're the position of powers, especially by giving them jobs. So, dear judge, you know, we are supposed to understand that nepotism is practiced in Africa. So, especially for those who are on top of the powers. So, dear judge, so we are to understand that nepotism, we are going to say that superpower nation introduced and launched the question of nepotism during the colonial eras. That's why till now nepotism takes place in Africa. So you my 14, you know, you are to change the changeable, accept the unchangeable, and remove yourself from unacceptable. So progressively, I like to criticize the someone who has come here and said presence of tribalism, of course, and you know, he talked much about the Hutu and Tutsi. So we have to understand that in Rwanda, the Tutsi and the Hutu were the same people, because you know, they were loving each other, you know, helping each other, and even, you know, greeting each other. So Mr. Dear Judge, what makes me blame him? Mr. Dear Judge, in 18th century, the Belgians, Germans, you know, who could rule the Rwanda and Burundis, first Tutsi and Hutus, you know, for Tutsi and Hutus carrying the ethnic identity cards. So, dear judge, through this fact, you know, I can say that, you know, superpower nations are the source of big problems in Africa, and not Africans themselves. You, my 14, you have to understand that we are neither unoptimistic, nor pessimistic, but a possibilistic. Senselessly, I like to criticize someone who has come here and said violation of democracy principle. So, dear judge, I don't get a picture, even negative, saying such a thing like this. When you come here, you're supposed to speak educationally, methodically, and honoringly. So, dear judge, talking about democracy.
Thank you. Clap him. I just want to say that he was the first contributor from supporting side. Right now, I just want to welcome the first contributor from opposing side. Anna McKay, the building, clap her. Five minutes.
First and foremost, I'm about to thank the God of ours, who the only by far the cleverest than ever, who does the thing both as effectively and efficiently as he can, created us in a good creation creatively. And as long as we're less clever than God is, we have to thank him for each and everything that will have been made by us recently, so much so that we can live this world in a peaceful fashion, because we really don't know first whether or not we're going to live it peaceably. However, I'm about to thank you, High Table in general, you both supporting and opposing side, caring over you, my fellow students, ladies and gents, good evening. Well, it is me who I am responsible for standing here before you by the reason of saying that, due to this afternoon motion which says, developed nations are the source of problems in Africa. And as long as I'm here the contributor, by the reason of contributing this marvelous contribution, which is still contributed by my fellow contributors there, my first contribution said that presence of homogarism. Dear judge, I am ever such braggadocio opening my mouth up for saying that many a country in Africa has been practicing this kind of thing, so-called homogarism. Before going further, let me explain the key concept of it. When we talk about homogarism, it means the situation where a person tries to achieve its political aims either by using certain ways or forcing without people's opinions. This is how homogarism is. And truthfully speaking, now have a look example in Zimbabwe there to Mr. Robert Mugabe. He has spent a good deal of time on his management, up approximately 36 years right now. Apart from this body, have a look example in Malawi to Mr. Joyce, to Mrs. Joyce Banda. She could announce publicly that she will govern now her position according to her father's position. And this could be the fact that many civilians of theirs were now horrendous for showing their reaction to their leaders. And this could be the result of having frequently wars, conflicts and others. But what amazing, UN could come in Africa by the reason of cooling down this kind of thing to not be continuously happening in Africa. Because they know from soup to night, from black to white, in and out that, falling in a river, they are in the boat. Falling in a well, they're the rope, but falling in a conflict. Is there any kind of hope? Precisely not. So this shows vividly that UN are in the front line making sure that they are solving, helping, eradicating for too many problems happening in Africa. So I still remain that giant nations or developed nations are not the source of problems in Africa, but Africans themselves are the source of it. And you supporting side, you are supposed to understand that we ourselves are the masters of our souls and are the captain of our minds. Dear Judge, you may see this is going on. But what distresses my heart is, if you come a participant from your team, lately, speak randomly, unconfidently, with a full of bad references as well, and say that our giant nation are the source of psychologically destroyed the African economy. I don't get a picture, even in negative. As long as you are in the darkness, let me put you on the lightness with a full of believeness. Actually, dear Judge, let's to turning back our mind on a back in a day stuff. Here, African, we were the world leading continent for producing clothes. Sympathetically, right away, we are in a third position after Indonesia from Asia. So this shows vividly that Africans themselves don't want to improve an economic of theirs so as to be both as acceptable and as marketable as ever, that all world can understand that for fear that they are going to be defeated by developed nations. But you are supposed to understand that not all defeat is final until we are stopped trying. So this shows vividly that Africans themselves are the source of destroying an economic of theirs, and it's not about developed nations. However, someone has come here recently and said that our developed nations are the source of motivating homosexuality. Oh my God. Actually, this is not true. Basically, it doesn't make a sense. Accordingly, though Mr. David Cameron could announce his voice up by the reason of motivating such a kind of thing, Africans could be given the high performance of saying that either they accept it or not. Have a look at example in two countries in Africa. Could he refuse it? For very example, to Mr. Robert Mugabe down Zimbabwe there. Apart from this body, but also the one who could refuse it is about Yoweri Museveni from Uganda. So this shows really that many a country in Africa, you know, are the source of practicing this kind of thing, so-called homosexuality. It's not about developed nations are the source of motivating this kind of thing. And you supporting side, you are supposed to understand that, and I mean actions speak louder than words. Have a look at example. Have we ever heard even a word to Mr. Jikan Bishop Kwete, who was managing his position at that time? Precisely not. Have we ever heard even a word to Mr. Jacob Zuma from South Sudan, who could, you know, manage his position that time? Precisely not. So this seems surely that, you know, Africans themselves are the source of practice the kind of thing.
Thank you. Clap her.
You're from opposing side. Right now, I just want to welcome the first speaker from supporting side. Yes!
First of all, I'm about to provide my reverential thanks to the God for not being you and me being at this scholarly gathering. More comprehensively, I'd like to thank High Table in general, yes, team and not team, without getting all the unique law students. A very good evening to everyone. Great, I am massively blissful being before your eyes, and I've just stood here for the convenience of supporting the motion which has been kept on the table. And the beautiful motion is, developed nations are the source of all problems in Africa. I do support this motion with the light of my unobjectionable point which I have on my piece of paper. My first point says, developed nations are the source of destructing African culture. Ultimately, developed nations are the source of this value African trade.
So, Mr. Dear Judge, allow me to explain my points one by one fastidiously. My first point says, developed nations are the source of disrupting African culture. First and foremost, we have to understand the meaning of culture. Culture means the customs and beliefs, art, way of life, social organization of a particular country or group. Broadly speaking, we've been witnessing around the world, every nation has its own culture. For instance, African culture, European culture, and American culture. Despite the fact that we are more passive that culture is the most important and significant thing around the world. Curiously enough, African culture becomes unvaluable by virtue of imitation of the culture. For instance, in terms of wearing style, much of a person puts on disreputable clothes. Apart from that, Mr. Dear Judge, in terms of eating style, so many people eat with spoon, fork, and stick as well. On condition that scientifically, if we just eat with spoon, fork, and stick as well, the food is indigestible. But honestly, if we just eat with our own hands, the food is going to be incredibly digestible, because always the digestive system starts down the palm, through the mouth to the stomach. Apart from that, Mr. Dear Judge, we have to understand that by imitating other culture, so many African people have been affected. For instance, hepatitis disease. So, Mr. Dear Judge, you may see it by your own eyes. Continuously, I would just like to pulverize someone who has come here and said carelessly that Africans themselves practice corruption. You, my four team, you have to understand that a liar can travel half a way where the truth is putting on his shoes. And you have to understand that talking about corruption is the abuse of public power for personal gain or benefit. First and foremost, if we talk about corruption, now we just have the organization so-called OCCRP, Organization Crime and Corruption Reporting Project. This organization was established by UN for the convenience of eradicating, removing, and solving the problem of corruption. And now, if they just stood confidently, firmly, for the convenience of...
Thank you.
Second contributor from supporting side. Right now, I just want to welcome the second contributor from opposing sides. Just clapping.
Okay, fine. A very good evening for everyone. From the outset of this academic gathering, I'd like to provide my innermost acknowledgement to the gathered mind, the one who put our source in that place for peace and calm. Secondly, I'm about to thank the beautiful high table in general. Yes, team, no team. Really, I will be by far the most thankless without thanking you, my fellow student, for your extraordinary participation in connection with the tension this moment. I negatively say no for meaning no negative. For the question that I've been kept on the table, it says, developed nations are the source of problems here in Africa. Mr. Judge, without killing my time, wholeheartedly, let me lay down my first pillar, which says, a business of archaic ICT technology. First and foremost, we have to understand that what is the meaning of ICT. ICT means information communication technology, and this is a new technology that is continually practicing in this world. So what makes me stress out is about here Africa. We fail to practice in a good way, and that's why we get difficulties of controlling our life. Knowing of this technology is very crucial. But, you know, on the other side of coin, coming to the judge nations are continually practicing this kind of thing in a good way. And that's why, you know, we call them developed one. So, if the worst come to the worst, we are supposed to use the other side of coin instead of demanding the same side of coin. A good example, a man from judge nation, so-called Bill Gates. This man has inaugurated a special program, so-called ICDL, with an eye to helping those Africans who do not know how to use a computer in a good way. As if not enough, as we know that here in Africa, our network is still in a grass level. So helping this kind of problems, this man, for the second time, has inaugurated another program, so-called Cisco Network Academy, with an eye to making our network in a good way. So if the nation are the source of problems here in Africa, why this man help Africa? So for this situation, it seems obvious that Jap Nation are the source of solving problem here in Africa. On top of all this, what's remained most particularly in my heart is coming for your speaker and say, you know, Jap Nation are the source of having better democracy here in Africa. You know, you first and foremost, we have to understand that, you know, no one can hide the fact that this kind of thing is not true, because a problem of ours here in Africa, we are very ignorant in terms of fighting this kind of thing, and that's why we get difficulties of controlling this kind of thing. So coming to the Jap Nation are good indeed in terms of practicing this kind of thing, and that's why they just practice this in a good way. So we Africans supposed to learn how should we practice democracy in a good way, because we've taken this kind of thing as a weapon to weaponize people, and that's why here in Zanzibar we discriminate each other between Unguja and Pemba. So for solving this problem, it's all about coping those ways that generation practice in these days. As you know enough, I like to criticize someone who has just come here and say failure of international organization. I don't get a picture, even a negative. Mr. Judge, you know, talking about international organization, particularly especially for UN, this organization contains so many organizations. Among them is about, you know, WHO, IMF, UNICEF, and others. Those organizations especially for solving different problems, for instance, in case of hunger, in case of health. So how will you come here and say, you know, our international organization is the source of, you know, problem here in Africa, while you are the one who take the flag?
Thank you. Clapping. To welcome the last contributor from supporting sides, Mudri, clapping.
Gladiator's friend.
Clapping once again.
Yes, come on.
Good evening. Actually, it is high time I brought my beautiful songs to God, who makes us excited about this debate. Secondly, I have to thank High Table in general. Yes, to nothing, without getting over, all my fellow students for your extraordinary participation. Ladies and gents, good evening once again. I'm very much tipping pink being before you rise for the convenience of saying yes of this question that has been kept on the table, which says developed nations are the source of all problems in Africa. Of course, dear judge, please allow me to explain my point, which says developed nations are the source of creating African citizens being unfaithful to their government. Eventually, developed nations hesitate solving African conflicts. Dear judge, my first point says developed nations are the source of creating African citizens being unfaithful to their government. Of course, dear judge, a mass of African leaders play the role of being patriotic for their countries, but they lose this treasure after being in power as the president because they face a lot of restriction from the developed countries. Dear judge, through this fraud, citizens start losing faith, knowing that their leaders are unfaithful to them. That's why we are given to see many African leaders persecuted, harassed, oppressed, killed, and executed as well by developed countries. Dear judge, vivid example, Mali, Ivory Coast, Kangaroo, and others. So this shows obviously that developed nations are the source of all problems in Africa. Dear judge, you may think for your own. On top of all this, what distresses me most, my heart is coming to the non-team speaker and say that our business of civil war. Remembering his words are very boring and tiring as well, because developed nations are the source of civil war in Africa. We have to ask ourselves, where do the rebels get strong weapons? So developed nations are the source of giving rebels weapons so that they can fight against their governments. Apart from that, someone has said about our border conflict, and he talked about Tanzania and Kenya. Dear judge, we have to understand that both countries were dominated by British. So British, you know, knows everything about this border. They know that this is a Kenya's border and this is Tanzania border. But what stresses me most, they were, you know, having happened this conflict, they were both silent and despicable as well. I can say that developed nations are the source of all problems in Africa. Apart from that, someone has said about power mongerism, and she talked about Robert Mugabe. Dear judge, you know, we saw in Libya what happened under Mohammed Gaddafi. Russia, French, and USA as well could interrupt the Muhammad Gaddafi killed him. But we have to ask ourselves, why don't they remove Robert Mugabe? Because they know, accordingly, that Zimbabwe, you know, there is no much a natural that they can get so that they can develop their countries. That's why they are not practically by far the most dutiful and dutiful and obedient as well in Africa. That's why
Just make clap. Putting side. And right now, I just want to welcome the last contributor from opposing sides. Clap him, Fanny's please.
First time each and everything, I'd like to bring my blessing thanks to my God, the one who left throughout me being in this gathering. Nevertheless, about to thank High Team in general, yes team and not team. Ladies and gents, good evening once again. I'm by far the most clever. I've been here before your eyes. With the convenience of posing some respect of the motion says, developed nations are the source of all problems in Africa. Anything but, Mr. Judge. Due to the unconscionable reason that I have my piece of paper, my first reason says, Africans themselves not practice the good leadership. Secondly, Africans themselves practice media injustice. Now, Mr. Judge, allow me to explain my point. My first point says, Africans themselves do not practice the good leadership. Really, Mr. Judge, we are giving to sing each and every day. We are giving to sing each and every day. Many African leaders have been accused in ICC, International Criminal Court, for going against the rule and regulation of a good leader. This is because the leader of Africa are not both as solicitous and as amenable as ever to the civilian. For instance, Uhuru Kenyatta in Kenya for practicing genocide in 2007, Joyce Banner in Malawi, Robert Mugabe in Zimbabwe for going against the constitution. This could bring the different, problem taking place in certain countries. For instance, killing each other, war, not only that, but poverty and others. This is because the civilian becoming a precarious moment. This is because the civilian becoming a precarious moment. As if not enough, Mr. Judge, even the wisest man ever to walk this earth, King Solomon, who say obviously that where knowledge lacks, people perish. And it is obvious that we African people are perishing, not for anything, but we've just lacked something known as knowledge. So to this, Mr. Judge, inasmuch as African has the brilliant people who are unable to understand the sweep of system of ruling their country, to this, Mr. Judge, I do always oppose that developed nations are not the source. Mr. Judge, you may see it on your own eyes. Now, Mr. Judge, allow me to say somebody who has just come and start saying developed nations create clashes and conflicts among the African countries. It is still an undeniable fact, Mr. Judge, because talking about classes have been divided in different categories. For instance, religious classes, color classes, political classes, but all type of classes are practiced publicly in Africa. For instance, in 2014, in Central African Republic, under the president, François Bozize, who was the main root of political classes between Christian people and Muslim people, anti-Balaka and Seleka. But Africans themselves could be silent. But what surprised me most is about developed nation and the chairperson of that cabinet, Federica Mogherini, who sit down and start figuring out the best ways of solving this kind of thing. And we could understand that they've assessed something known as interim government so as to make sure that this kind of thing can be solved peacefully. But once after choosing somebody known as Captain Samba Panza as interim president of Central African Republic, we couldn't understand this kind of thing taking place anymore. This shows obviously developed nations are not the source of problem in Africa, but Africans themselves. Because if Africans themselves are not the source, why could they be silent? Given Mr. Judd, to this I do always believe that Africans themselves are the source of all problems in this country. Now, Mr. Judge, allow me to say somebody who has just come and start saying, hesitating African problem, in Africa. Really, Mr. Judge, it doesn't give me a picture, even a negative. Because talking about Africa, Africa has the brilliant people who have much of education.
Thank you. Thank you. What I just want to say, he was the last contributor from opposing side. Right now, we've completed it and everything about the second phase. Now we're about to finish the last phase in terms of question. Without wasting our own time,
I just want to welcome the first questionnaire from supporting site. Just clap her, clap her, clap her, clap her. Just be tired.
First of all, I'd like to thank you and everyone for being here. Secondly, thank you, Hector in general. Yes, team and nothing. Ladies and gents, a very good evening to everyone.
Good evening.
I am from supporting team to ask the question. My question says that if you say developed nations are not the source of all problems, why do many countries in Europe help the rebels in Africa?
Before leaving, have you understood the question? Just come again and shorten your question as well, according to the time.
If you say developed nations are not the source of all problems, why do many countries in Europe help the rebels in Africa?
Okay, before leaving, have you understood the question? Just leave for good. Clap her.
Again.
Good evening, good evening, good evening.
What a question. But the matter is, first you're supposed to understand that arguing with the stupid people is like killing a mosquito in a check. Either you may or not killing it, but you the end slap yourself. But the matter is, exactly that developed nations are the source of giving, you know, Africa as a kind of, you know, instrument. But they are giving them by the reason of protecting against their enemies. Have a look example. There are too many terrorists that we have in Africa. So they use them by the reason of protecting themselves against terrorists and other calamity. That's all.
Thank you. We've completed each and everything about question from supporting sites. Right now, I just want to welcome these sites to run the point of question.
Just clapping.
Yes, come on.
Good evening. Yeah. I've just stood here with Night to asking you the question. I am inquisitive, you know, to ask you the question. But before asking you the question, I have to remind one thing, you know. You know, there is none but will agree with you in this kind of motion. And my question is, if you say developed nations are the source of problem in Africa, in African countries, why do South Sudan leaders fight against each other after being assisted by developed nations to get their sovereignty?
Have you understood the question?
Come again.
Just come again, yeah. And shorten your question as well.
Yeah.
Come again, why, and shorten it.
Why do South Sudan leaders fight against each other after being assisted by developed nations to get their sovereignty?
Thank you. They've understood. Just clap him, clap him, clap him, clap him.
Good evening once again. Actually, the question is very much cool. But we have to understand, in Sudan we have Juba Sudan and Haut Sudan. But what distresses me most are seeing that developed nations help rebels for the sake of fighting against government. We have to ask ourselves, those veterans' power, if you talk about veterans' power, you talk about Russia, French, England, and China. So are they really defeated of fighting against terrorists in Sudan? Of course not. What they want is about natural resources from Sudan. That's why they help and contribute much confrontation in Sudan. That's all.
Thank you. Moment. Facing, you know, my fellow teachers, just to say some, starting with the timekeeper from Long Media. Just clapping, 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 clapping.
Assalamu alaikum. Clap yourselves. First of all, I'd like to thank Allah for his mercy and blessings. And secondly, I'd like to thank my fellow teachers and you, my dearest students, ladies and gentlemen. Assalamu alaikum once again. So happy my God that I wings I could fly over and over. And I could do that as the way of showing the great happiness which I'm floating on right now. But I was just like, I can say like, because I'm not really timekeeper. I was on behalf of T. Eminem because he was absent. So, but I've just seen your performance and you are dramatically performed performing here, and of course you've put myself over, and I'd like to consider the only way that can pull up or can stabilize our level of our speaking. So sometimes we may come across different things in learning, but you know, when the anger rages, it easily cut it out, just like the storm waters of the sea. So sometimes controlling the motion has to be. So guys, shift back to the calm waters, and thank God that you leave the tide the tide. So when anger sparks, it resembles lunatic fire, saying nothing without being fanatic, being nothing without being pragmatic. So one more episode of the shift, and you'll be the one doing the shift. I got no more to say. Thank you all, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you! Clap your hands!
First of all, I'd like to convey my enormous gratitude to ITAPL in general, without forgetting your students, for attentively listening. I stayed there all the time detecting and recording some mistakes, and I got some views, and I'll try to mention and correct them. There's a common mistake. Let me start with this one. Some people use this word really. It's not a good use using this word really, I mean adverb, without a subject. Like saying really Mr. Judge is not a good practice. You better say that Mr. Judge, really this and this, then proceed. Or if you want to use this adverb really at the beginning, show it a surprise. Like really, I think it's understood. Someone said that this bring tears. This bring tear, we know that simple present tense when we use positive statement with the word this. This is like it. Third person singular, we put S. This brings tears. And someone said that African themselves, there's no African themselves. Them comes from word they, and they is plural. So African themselves. This could sound correctly. Right? And someone, this could sound better if you say that I want to criticize someone and remove article that. You are supposed to understand. You are supposed to understand. This is used as passive voice. You are supposed to understand. And someone said that, let me criticize someone who was just coming. Let me criticize someone who came here. Would be enough. And the last thing I want to say that, the repeating of the word. Some people again and again and again, this is not good practice. It's like we don't have vocabularies. It's not good, and some people repeat the word. The first person come, say something, then people come and repeat, like people are using this word. I don't find the picture even negative. Everyone was doing that. This doesn't sound good. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kathy! He was untouchable Dr. Grammar from Sparkling English class. Right now, I just want to welcome Master of pronunciation, no? From Sparkling English class. Just clap him. It's going to be good of you to stand right here. It's going to be good of you to there. Thank you, as long as you are my big bro, fine.
But I know what it's going to be.
Well enough. And let me say, well, I never my young, it's not going away. Even if I don't speak towards you very often, I've been listening to you there in terms of pronunciation. Even us, we are talking much, all of articulation error yet. And the problem is, you towards that annoying thing. This is our problem. But if we take this as we begin the year a teacher, we can't go very far wrong. And we can't speak appropriately like the Londoners themselves do. Yeah. And here's some mistakes. Someone comes here and say, you should understand it that the real pronunciation is understand and not understand. Yeah. Moreover, someone comes here and say, Odbet. This is Odb, and not Odb. The translation of that word is Odb. Yeah. And I just say, someone come here and say, by our Ronias, this is by our ear, by our own ear. Just say by your own ear, Yeah. And someone's come here and say, extraordinary.